Hi, everyone. My name is Bailey Bursick, and I'm joined here with my colleague, Meryl Fernando. This is part two in our series of Windows Slope for Business Cloud Kerberos Trust. So if you haven't already watched part one, be sure to go back and do so, where we cover how provisioning and authentication works and go over some of the prerequisites. Now we're going to jump into a demo.
Let's start by configuring our group policy. So you can see we've got an OU where we have two policies. This enables FIDO2 hybrid sign-in, and the other one enables Windows Hello for Business authentication. And when we look at that group policy, it's just two settings: enable Windows Hello for Business and Cloud Trust for on-premises authentication. So that's all set. The next thing we're going to set up is Azure AD Kerberos. We've already installed the PowerShell module here, and now we are going to configure this for our on-premises Active Directory. Let's save the domain admin's credential for the domain that we're trying to configure. Okay, and now let's take a look and see what we have configured already. So what we're going to do is a get Azure AD Kerberos. The domain is going to be happyfunball.local, and our domain credential is what we saved earlier. And we're going to give it a user principle. So we've got our domain Active Directory domain credentials, and we're going to give it a UPN of a global admin. Okay. One thing we do want to note is this is an administrative PowerShell. To run this command, you need to have local admin privileges on the system you're running. And this system must be a member of the forest that you're trying to configure. It doesn't have to be a member of the domain, but it has to be in the same forest. So we'll go ahead and run this, and we'll sign in as the admin user here. And we can see that we don't have anything configured yet. So let's go ahead and actually configure that. It's just a matter of changing one character to set. And that's it. Now we've configured Azure AD Kerberos, we've set up Windows Hello for Business, Cloud Kerberos Trust Group Policy, and let's go now and sign in as the user. The first thing it's going to do is ask the user to perform a multi-factor authentication. Now what the administrator has done for this user is issued them a temporary access pass, which allows them to sign in without having to set up the Authenticate app or another form of MFA. So they enter their temporary access pass, and they can now set up Hello for Business. They set up the PIN for Windows Hello for Business. And that's it. The user is now all set to start using Windows Hello for Business. So let's log out and now try to sign in. This time we are going to use the Windows Hello for Business sign in. So the user is now prompted for the PIN. They enter the PIN, no password required. And this time the user is able to completely sign in and they are into their desktop. Now the user is completely authenticated. They can get to on-prem resources. They can get to their system volume. They can launch Edge and sign in. They are already single signed in. And they're able to get to any of the applications that are integrated with Entra ID as well without having to do an authentication. They directly get single signed on and get to all of the applications. In a nutshell, that's Windows Hello for Business. Right, so let's look a little bit into the prerequisite checks. Now, this is what gets folks tripped up as you're deploying Windows Hello for Business. Now, these prerequisite checks are actually constantly taking place on Windows, on the Windows devices that your users are using. It's constantly checking to see if the policy is enabled and whether provisioning should begin. Now, even before you start in this journey, you can look in the Windows event logs under application services in the user device registration log, and you can see the checks being performed. Now, there are some things that the OS doesn't check before Windows Hello for Business provisioning, and that could cause provisioning to fail. Some are obvious, like if you're going to reach out to the Entra device registration service, well, the device needs to have internet connectivity. These prerequisite checks don't check to make sure they're connected before prompting the user to provision. So for Entra hybrid join devices, you also need line of sight to the domain controller for that first login. So you really need to have a plan in place or prep your users, like to connect to a VPN or be in the office before provisioning, so they have this line of sight for that initial registration to take place. We check to see if the user has the primary refresh token, but we don't check to see if it's healthy or current. So when troubleshooting a failed Hello for Business registration, you'll need to check these yourself in the event logs. Right. Then we come to the last part of it, right? And this is the most important part and the one that's going to take time to do. And that is to ensure that your users set up Hello for Business for the first time on their devices. To ensure you have a successful rollout, we recommend educating your users on how to use Windows Hello for Business and what multi-factor authentication is and what biometric authentication is, and provide clear instructions and guidance on how to enroll. To help with this, we published end-user communication templates that can be used for starting prepping your users for Hello for Business. We'll share those links here. You can click on that and download those templates. So these include templates for MFA, for all of your passwordless credentials. They're all in the same place. And that's about communicating to end users. And the last part is, once you roll it out, you'll want to monitor the progress of your Hello for Business deployment. Now, using authentication methods, activity report, which tracks both registration and usage of Hello for Business, you can review and see what's happening. So one important thing is that you can't enforce Hello for Business registration to be completed. So even though your policies will prompt the user and continue to prompt if they fail out of MFA a couple of times, it will allow them to bypass registration, but we'll keep prompting them again. So in the login screen, the users can still opt to use the password instead of Hello for Business. There is a policy that you can force Hello for Business, but it is problematic and it's not something we recommend that you use right now. What you can do is track the progress with the reporting and target your messaging to non-compliant users. Or an alternate option is to scramble their password if you have a need to completely enforce Hello for Business as the only sign-in method.
Now that you've seen the demo, I want to quickly recap your Windows Hello for Business deployment plan. First, pick which trust type is best for your business use cases. We highly recommend you go with Cloud Primrose Trust unless you have a compelling reason not to. Then ensure all of the prerequisites are in place, deploy your policies, and encourage your end users to get involved. We also have quite a few bits of documentation to help you get started and to follow along, so be sure to take a screenshot of these up on the screen. Now, thank you so much for joining us, and good luck with deploying Windows Hello for Business.